Okay, so here we're being asked to find the derivative of 3t minus t squared. So first things first, the fact that this is a t really doesn't change anything at all. It's just instead of calling the variable x, we're now calling it t. So we've literally just changed the letter, but nothing else has changed. Okay, so to find this derivative, we're going to go back to the definition. The limit as h approaches 0 of f of t plus h minus f of t, all divided by h. And then we're just going to do what we've been doing and plug this in for every t we see, and also this. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. And just a reminder, for those of you coming into this video, you might know a shortcut to find this derivative, but we're starting by taking derivatives using the definition, and then we're going to work our way to those shortcuts. So in terms of the series of this course, this video hasn't gotten that far yet. Anyways, let's just continue. We have 3 times t plus h, so I plugged that t plus h in for the first t, minus t plus h squared. So that's the whole first chunk. That's f of t plus h. And then we have to subtract just f of t, which is 3t minus t squared, all over h. And now we just have some simplifying to do. This is going to be 3t plus 3h, so I just expanded that. Minus, and then this minus sign is first we can expand, and then we can distribute that minus sign. So this is going to be t squared plus 2th plus h squared. To distribute that minus sign, I'm just going to erase these brackets and change all the signs. So these are going to be all minus signs. So minus, minus, this is squared. And then we have minus 3t plus t squared. So this minus sign also distributes. Okay, all over h. Now let's see what we can take care of here. This 3t and that 3t can go away. This negative t squared and positive t squared can go away. And I think that looks like that's the only thing, or the only things. This is a really ugly yellow. I have to change my yellow color. But for now, I'll just actually change colors. And I hope I didn't offend any of you who think that that yellow is pretty. I don't prefer it. Okay. So what do we have left here? We have a positive 3h, a minus 2th, and a minus h squared, all divided by h. Well, it looks like we can factor an h out of the numerator, so let's go ahead and do that. And we're left with 3 minus 2t minus h, all times by h, so I factored an h out. And now those can cancel, and we're left with something that's going to work out really nicely, it looks like. The limit as h approaches 0 of 3 minus 2t minus h. Well, we can plug this 0 in for h now. And once we do that, we're going to get 3 minus 2t minus 0, which of course the minus 0 doesn't contribute anything. So this is 3 minus 2t. That's the derivative. So the derivative, so f prime of t, the derivative of this function, is 3 minus 2t. Okay, so let's, again, this is, all we've done so far is basically the algebra of simplifying this limit. Let's take a look at what this actually means. So here is a graph. In red, we have the function 3t minus t squared. In green, we have its derivative, which we said was 3 minus 2t. Sorry, let me get this on screen here. Okay. Now let's see if we can do some analysis. Now what we said is the values of the derivative, so this line in green, the values of the derivative tell us the slope of the function. So here we see, let's say, when when x is negative 1, the derivative is positive 5. This is a 5 here. So that tells us that the slope of the tangent line to the original function is positive 5. Let's look at another example. When x is negative 2, we go up and over. Well, there's not a tick mark there, but we could figure it out by just plugging negative 2 in here. We'd have 3 minus negative 4, so plus 4, so that's 7. So this would be 7. So what that tells us is when x is negative 2, the slope of the tangent line to the original function is negative 7. So if we went rise over run, it would be, the slope would be negative 7. Now, an interesting thing happens. Look at, if the derivative is 0, meaning it crosses the axis, then the slope of the tangent line is 0, has no slope. See, a horizontal tangent line. A horizontal line has no slope. Notice also that the derivative then goes negative, and now look at, all of these slopes are negative. So you're hopefully starting to get an idea that we can really use the derivative to help us analyze the behavior of the function. Because we just like I just said, we look, when the derivative is negative, that tells us the slopes are negative. When the derivative is positive, it tells us the slopes are positive. Well, positive slope means the function is increasing. Negative slope means the function is decreasing. If the derivative is 0, that means the function is neither increasing nor decreasing. It's kind of leveled off for the moment. So these are ideas that we can use to help us analyze the behavior of functions. Okay, see you in the next video.